Are you freaking out right now? A little anxious, wondering how the hell you ended up here? Well, you are not alone. Every single one of us that's ever been to grad school and got out of it has felt the exact same thing that you're feeling right now. But I want you to take a deep breath. These five tricks and life hacks are gonna get you through anything that you're about to face, whether it be medical school, PA school, or any type of grad school. None of the things I'm about to talk about are easy changes, but if you can implement them into your daily routine and your rituals, you are going to not only make it through grad school, but you are going to thrive, you're gonna grow, evolve, and you're gonna thank yourself for it for the rest of your life, because these five things are gonna become part of your daily rituals, hopefully, and they're gonna make you into a better, more successful, and happier human being. So the first thing that I wanna talk about is mindset. Now, if you're doing what you do for the right reasons, say you wanna be a doctor and you're doing it for the most altruistic reasons, then this isn't gonna be an issue for you. You're gonna wake up, you're gonna study with a purpose, you're gonna go to work with a purpose, because you know what you're studying for, and that's so that you can achieve what you've always dreamed of. And you need to hold that very close no matter what you're doing, because it can get painful. When you're studying, remember why you're studying, remember who you're studying for. When you're going to work every day, waking up at 4 or 5 a.m., remember why. And this becomes tricky if you're not doing it for the right reasons, which unfortunately is a lot more people than you would expect. A lot of people are pressured into this by their friends or family or society, or think that by going to grad school and getting this degree, you're gonna have a better life and make more money. This is gonna be very challenging for you, but you need to try and fix your mindset to convince yourself that you are doing this for that right reason. Find the reason and hold on to it. There's a lot of good resources that can teach you how to do this. I highly suggest the book Think and Grow Rich. It's a great audiobook, and it basically teaches you how to hack your mind and trick you into believing things that you didn't otherwise believe, tricking your subconscious every single day. And eventually you start latching on to this thought, this idea, this identity that you've been convincing yourself of, and that'll make it a lot easier. It's something to hold on to while you're studying and working, waking up saying, I'm doing this for this reason. It will get you through whatever struggles that you need to get through. So the second and possibly the most important thing on this list is winning the morning. And this is something that I didn't learn how to do until later on in life. If you're a night owl or don't identify as a morning person, you need to erase that from your brain, because you're never gonna make it through this. You're never gonna reach the goals that you wanted to reach. You need to win the morning, and that's because of positive momentum. If you start the day strong by beating that little voice in your head that says, just go to bed, wake up and eat this muffin, you don't need to go to the gym today. The more wins you have over that little voice, and that's not hitting the snooze button, getting up and making your bed, getting to the gym before anyone starts bothering you at 5, 6 a.m., doing a mile run, having a nutritious breakfast. They're little wins, but what they do is they stack up and they create positive momentum for the rest of your day. And no matter what you have to do that day, whether it's studying for 12 hours, going to your 14-hour surgical rotation that you hate, dealing with people that you hate, if you win that first morning that no one else can control, and you start your day happy with gratitude and momentum, you're gonna have an awesome day every day. And not only that, you're gonna perform at a higher level than all of your colleagues and all of your classmates. And if you're interested in my morning ritual, my morning routine that I created for myself, there's gonna be a follow-up video on that that you can check out. So the number third, and this is obvious, I don't even have to tell you guys, but it is so critically important for each and every one of you to actually let it soak in and understand that if you're not eating right and you're not exercising, none of the other things are gonna work for you. If you're feeding your body crap and you're not respecting your body enough to go out and take a walk, take a run, lift some weights, your body is literally the vehicle that's gonna be taking you through all of these challenges and the next, you know, for the rest of your life, screw the next 4 years. You need to make sure that that vehicle is well oiled. If it's not, you're feeding it crap, you're not exercising, your body's not gonna have the energy to sustain all of the emotional and physical trauma that you're about to put it through. But if that thing is well oiled, if you have a balanced diet, you're eating your fruits, vegetables, you're exercising at least 3 times a week, which all of you can do, time is not an excuse. You can do this. This should be your first priority if you're not already doing it. And you know, just because I'm preaching diet and exercise doesn't mean that I don't cheat. If you love, you know, a cookie, you can eat cookies once a week and it's not gonna kill you. Still, you know, feed your soul too. But remember that your body is literally your vehicle and you need to take better care of it. Little hack relating to exercise, the first excuse that everyone makes is I don't have the time. I'm gonna call BS on that, because if I have the time, you have the time. And if that means waking up at 4 a.m., 5 a.m. some days, and going to sleep a little earlier, figure out how to make yourself do that. If you wake up at 4 or 5 a.m., I guarantee you, no one's bothering you. You have no other responsibilities. Gyms are open. You can get yourself in the gym early in the morning. And as we talked about earlier, with that positive momentum, You are going to love yourself for it. So the fourth thing that I want to talk about, and this is another one that I only recently, in the last year or two, really implemented into my daily rituals, is meditation. Meditation, I think, is the secret sauce that nobody wants to drink because of all kinds of excuses. I can't do it, my mind's too active, I have anxiety, I don't have time for meditation. Really, only it takes 10 minutes a day, it costs no money. All you have to do is sit on this couch with no distractions and focus on your breathing for 10 minutes. And there's tons of resources online to teach you how to do this practice successfully. And meditation is literally, it's not some Eastern medicine hoodoo. Meditation has proven results with the research. I suggest you go look at it. And what it's gonna do is it's the act of physically exercising and strengthening your mind so that you can focus effectively, so you don't have to be pumping amphetamines into your body so that you can study. Meditation fixes that. It also gives you emotional stability. So when you're feeling depressed or anxious, it makes you be able to stop and it clicks. It's like, oh my God, I'm having these feelings, this is why. And then it just takes you back to what you need to be doing and what you need to be focusing on. And if you need some resources to start meditating and you don't know how to start, Headspace is an awesome app. I have it on my phone. It actually works with my Alexa too, where I just turn it on with my voice and it guides me through a 10-minute meditation every day. Super easy to do, highly suggested for any beginners out there that wanna start taking it up. Make this a part of your daily ritual. You'll thank yourself for it. Number five, and this one is gonna sound like new age hooey, but you need to feed your soul. And everybody's different. For me, it's animals and nature. I know what makes me get that cleanse to my soul after a long week of studying or working really hard. Being around animals and being in nature really just cleanses me of all of that buildup that happens over the course of weeks and months of nonstop, you know, board studying, really hard rotations that you're on, or whatever it might be for you. You need to figure out what that happy place is for you, where you can go and escape from technology, take some deep breaths, and just fill your body with whatever it is that you love to do or love to be in. Whether it's sports, animals, I think nature's an awesome one for everyone. Everyone should get out in nature, take your shoes off, and just lay there. Turn your phone off. Cleansing your soul is really important because you guys know just as well as anyone, studying and cramming, anxiety and tests, it all builds up in us somewhere that really can't be defined. And if you don't purge that of yourself, that's when people burn out. And you really can purge it if you just take, you know, 5-10 minutes to yourself to get out there and figure it out what it is that you need to do to have that release. So those are the five things. And the important thing to remember is that you don't have to implement all five at once. Growing takes time and it's not easy to do all at once. If you can do even 2 or 3 of these things at the same time, then props to you. The more that you apply, the better. And remember that self-love is self-discipline. Take this time to do these things for yourself is the greatest act of self-love. And we all have like studier's guilt, worker's guilt. When we're not studying, we feel guilty. It's not right to be outside when we should be in here studying when everyone else is, but that's totally wrong. If you spend all of your time studying and working, you're gonna burn out and you're not gonna be happy, and that's no way to live your life. Love yourself, discipline yourself, and do these things that are gonna really help benefit your soul. A lot of people have done this. I made it through 4 years of medical school with all of my hair while operating a business, taking care of a puppy, maintaining a social life, and doing all kinds of other things. If I can do it, you can. You just have to take on this identity. You have to believe in yourself. And if you do that, no one can stop you. You're gonna make it through this thing. You're gonna grow and evolve into the doctor or lawyer or whatever it is that you wanna be. You guys, also super important, remember how lucky you are to have this opportunity. Gratefulness will get you through a lot of rough times. There are millions and millions of people all over the world that would kill to be in your shoes right now. So remember that when you wake up every day. Remember that when you go to sleep. Remember that when you're studying. Be super grateful. Really make that a part of your daily practice because you are lucky and you're gonna make it through this at the end and you're gonna be so proud of yourself. You just have to hang in there. Try and love yourself. Try and practice these disciplines and you're gonna do it. We all did it. If you want to talk about anything that I mentioned before in this video, or if you have any questions, or just need some motivation on a hard day, shoot me a direct message on Instagram. I respond to every single one of them. It's at Dr. J Feldman. I'm here for you. I believe in you. And seriously, take me up on that offer. Shoot me a message. Go crush it, guys.